Okay. Good afternoon. Everyone hearing my voice. Wow, such amazing, you know, to come on board today to share a very interesting stuff I have heard in TBC, like I promised in my first video that I said I'm going to be sharing to you guys my second journey in TBC, how I was involved in police case, mostly because of TBC. Yeah. So I'm gonna be continuing. My name is Odenibo Valentine, aka TBC Professor. And by the grace of the Almighty God, I am a member of TBC, ambassador of TBC. TBC ambassador. Because TBC has changed my life, and indeed, I'm glad to be part of TBC movement today. So, I would like to begin this way. I want to talk about lion and the sheep. Who are lions and who are sheep? Yes. The reason I have to start this way is because I have really pondered over a particular thing that so many people are ignorant of. Because they just want to join the masses and the elite dictation way of life and remaining as a slave to them, to the slave masters, of which I've broken off from it. Yeah. Now, in TBC journey, I have taken myself to be a lion. Yes, a lion. A lion, that is what I'm going to talk about today. After today, my next video is going to be on ego. Because in TBC, you must be a lion. In TBC, you must be an ego if you must succeed. If you must move on, if you must carry on this vision of TBC, you must stand to be these two things. Number one, you must be a lion. Then number two, you must be a sheep. You must be an ego, not a sheep, rather. You must be an ego. Okay, today, I'm going to be explaining to you why I said I am a lion in TBC. Because lions don't lose sleep over the opinions of the sheep. Lions don't lose sleep over the opinions of the sheep. How do I mean? I'm going to explain to you in details. Yes. I'm going to explain. The life of a sheep. Now let's take a look at sheep. Yes, man. The life of a sheep is easier than the life of a lion. The life of a sheep is easier than the life of a lion. Pay adequate attention to understand my fact. Why I said that the life of a sheep is easier than the life of a lion. Number one, sheep are given food and water freely by their shepherds. Sheep are given food and water freely by their shepherds. Fact number two, sheep are protected from predators by shelters they did not build. Sheep are protected from predators by shelters they did not build. Sheep fatten themselves on the shepherd's food, thriving into a multitude that outnumbers the lions. It is hard to find out that we have, it might be difficult to believe me on this notion, that we have more sheep than the lions. You know why? Sheep outnumbers the lions in multitude because they are given food and water freely by their shepherds. They are protected from predators by the shelter they did not build. But I must tell you something today. All these sheep seeking for all this comfort, but these comforts bind the sheep into slavery. The comfort, okay, I am very comfortable being an employee. I am very comfortable serving and serving and serving. Oh, come on. I'm a free man, born in a free town. Yes, I ought to exhibit my freedom. There is freedom. In fact, there is freedom. I ought to have this freedom because this freedom is given to me by God Himself. Financial freedom. I need it. Societal freedom, I need it. But come to think about it, politics, games played in the country today. Human rights are now restricted. While some set of people are there enriching themselves more and more. The sheep are bred to be weaker of mind, hey, and body. Because the kind of food given to sheep makes them to feel that they've gotten everything, the coverage they needed. And in doing so, they are trained to have weaker mind and body. For a sheep to have food from the shepherd, the sheep need to have the shepherd's protection so greatly that they can be free of physical chains but never stray. Look at sheep, for instance. Yes, because I'm a cat. I was once a cattle rider, you know, and when we get a sheep and a place where we take care of them, we can't release the sheep, they will be playing around. But they are protected, there is a wall built that they can't go beyond that particular limit. You get my point now? That is the life of a sheep. The elites have made the citizens sheep. That is what? Slavery. They feel like they are not physically bound. They are not physically chained. But they can never stray away beyond their limits. There is a lifetime of servitude for sheep. Being a sheep, I tell you, you will remain in the servitude business, serving others. And when eventually a person gets old, there is nothing to show. Nothing, absolutely nothing. So many people are waiting for pension. The time I will pay the pension, you are she. I will remain in the lifetime of servitude. One that is comfortable but never ends, but ends at the shepherd's whim. You are comfortable being an employee in servitude, but ends at the shepherd's whim. Shepherd controls you. Who are shepherd in the world economy today? The elites. The citizens are the sheep. But thank God I've broken off. I'm standing as a lion today in TBC. Lions have no masters. I am glad to tell you, lions have no masters. I will explain further to you, for you to understand. Though the lion must hunt for its own food, though the lions must hunt for its own food and search for its own shelter, yes, it is free to roam where it wishes and requires no one to open the gate. Oh my goodness. Lions requires no one to open the gate, though the feeding trough of the sheep is filled. It is only with the grass and grain of its master's choosing. I'm going to explain to you this. The trough of a sheep is filled, but it is only the master, the shepherd, that can determine the kind of grain and grass that will be poured into that trough for the sheep to feed on. A lion must hunt and chase its meals, but feasts on anything it catches. Lion is free to move. The king of the jungle. No wonder TBC is the king of all cryptos. The king of all cryptos. That's TBC. The billion coin is a king. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. Such amazing, you know. I'm going to tell you something today. Lion feeds on anything it catches. Wealth and success never come to those who simply wait for them to arrive. Point to note in this video. Wealth and success never come to those who simply wait for them to arrive. What does it mean? You have to get up. If you must succeed, you must get up, because TBC is movement. TBC is freedom. TBC is liberty. You must rise up and talk to people about TBC. You must rise up and promote TBC. You must rise up and share the love. One love. If you share the love to others, because I used to tell people that in a particular community and a particular person is a millionaire, and you refuse to help those people in that community to become millionaires, I tell you, the same people you ignored will cook up against you for your kidnapping. They will gang up against you to kidnap you, because they will want to get that money. You refuse to tell them the way forward. Now is the time to gather people, educate them, tell them about TBC. TBC is already on that mission to end poverty globally. Some humans choose to be sheep. It's very painful. Some humans choose to be sheep. They desire freedom, but rely on others to provide their comforts. Striving for riches, but investing little effort to attain it. Little effort they put in to attain it. They scream in protest when they are fenced and herded. They scream. angry that they are not free like the lions, but accept the shepherd's food nonetheless. Though they rebel by day, they always wander home to their cages by night. What are you? Are you a sheep or are you a lion? Do you want to remain in a cage? You are headed during the day, in the night you go back to cage. Only a fool believes that all deserve equal rewards for unequal effort. My dear people, everyone in the world hearing the sound of my voice today, I must tell you, it is only a fool who believes that everyone all deserves equal rewards. Why will all deserve equal rewards for unequal effort, for crying out loud? My effort differs from yours, and the expect both of us to have equal reward. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen, never. Because the amount of force, the work, the effort, the time, the strategy I've implemented in this particular business differs from yours, and they expect one of us to deserve a reward. No, never, it's not going to happen. It's only a fool that thinks that way. I applied two efforts, you applied one, and they expect one of us to have the same result. Equal result. Never. Now I want to talk to the leaders. If you must be a leader, leaders must have unwavering confidence in their decision to choose effort over leisure. I want to really congratulate some of our top leaders in TBC community. They are extremely doing well. They are doing well. I was in the live section with Dan Ewa and Derek this afternoon, the same body meeting. It was amazing. It was awesome. Dan Ewa is a leader with such a quality that is amiable. I want to thank all our leaders worldwide. They are trying their best. It means that these leaders, they have an unwavering confidence in their decision to choose effort over leisure. You see, this is say that work before pleasure. You have to work first before pleasure comes. The reward for labor is wages and salary. There must be labor first. You must be a leader. I know the things I faced when my first Abuja trip. Because of TBC. I was promoting TBC, I traveled down to Abuja, from Lagos to Abuja, as a leader of my group. It wasn't easy, but I worked. And my happiness is when I see my people that came through me, when I see their success, their achievements, it gladdens my heart as a leader over them. As human, sheep boast of their slothful lives of ease, and criticize anyone who work to better themselves. Sheep boast of their slothful lives of ease. They also criticize anyone who work to better themselves. I've chosen to work to better my life. I've chosen to work to better myself. I've chosen to work to better my community. And many sheep are there criticizing, calling TBC different names, whatever they like. They should call it, I don't care. But I know TBC is real. TBC rocks. the shepherds pay no heed at all to the complaint of the sheep. I'm not a sheep, I'm a lion. Yes. Mockery. Mockery is weak when shouted through the bars of a cage. Mockery is weak when shouted through the bars of a cage. Wow, interesting. Many that criticize TBC, they mock TBC, they call TBC names. They're only shouting through the bars of a cage because we are over 2 million people, community strong than ever before. Now I want to ask a question. Do you think is the lion's stupidity that keeps it from a life of leisure? Do you think so? This is a question. Answer me in the comment box below. Yes, I need an answer. I want to know what your answers would be. Is it the lion's stupidity that keeps it from a life of leisure? How can so many sheep be wrong as they grow fatter on the shepherd's food? Why would any creature choose to run free in the dangerous and uncertain wilderness? Humans are not born as sheep or lions, but must choose a path for themselves. You must choose a path for yourself. You must. You must choose a path. Path, yes. You must choose a path. Either a path to be happy or the path to be sorrowful. And remain engaged. Bam. Yes. You have to choose a path. You must choose one. There must be a path you must choose. Either the path of the sheep or the path of the lion. Will you strive for what is easy and safe? To follow close to the multitude, to remain within the fences that protect you from the outside but imprison you within its boundaries? Or will you travel the path you choose, exploring freely in the dangerous forest of life, leading your own way in a planet filled with followers? As for me, I have chosen to lead my own path. The way of the planet that filled with abundance, and that is TBC. Remember, at sunset, yes, at sunset, the sheep are headed back into their prison. And fed until they drift into sleep. The lion enjoys no such promises. Lions wandering upon the mountains in search of a meal, hungry but free. Freedom! I come here to speak freedom to you people out there hearing the sound of my voice. Those of you that have been listening, that have been watching this video, I will encourage you to play the part of a lion. Lions enjoy no such promises, but they wander upon the mountains in search of meal. Lions go hungry sometimes, but they are free. Seek freedom first. Freedom from slavery. When you seek freedom, then you regain consciousness to think initiatively, to think creatively, to think a better way of doing things. Until you are free, you will never understand. Was it not the same thing that Nelson Mandela sought for? Freedom. That racism should be cancelled. The blacks and the whites. Freedom. Freedom. We need freedom. What freedom are we talking about in TBC? Financial freedom from slavery. Yes. Enough is enough. It's time to rise up and work. Remember, though the lion lacks the comfort of a shepherd's security, a lion never wishes for the life of a sheep. A lion may hunger while a sheep is fed. A lion, please note this quote, a lion may hunger, may go hungry while the sheep are fed. But the fattest sheep, oh my goodness, the fattest of the sheep is the lion's meal. When the lion catches up the sheep, the lion eats it up, everything. So join us in TBC and become a lion instead of a sheep. Become a lion instead of a sheep. The life of a lion is filled with goodies. Now, what really got me interested about TBC? You might be asking, why? Why? TBC is divine. What I mean divine is this, divine. TBC is created based on the formula we call Lord's formula. And the Lord's formula is based on abundance and prosperity. Abundance and prosperity. That's a formula TBC is created. Last year, November 2017, the case I got myself involved and that led to police arrest. I'm glad to share this today to the whole world to hear my voice, because it is the truth that people fight against. The truth. No one cares about a lie. Yeah. No one cares about, or do you care about lies? No. It's the truth that people want to cage. People want to imprison the truth from coming out, because truth will expose their wickedness. Truth will expose their evil acts. Truth will expose their evil agenda. The same truth. So precisely November last year, 2017, one of my guy that I introduced TBC to called me on phone that he wanted to see me. Just came back from business trip, so he invited one of the eateries of which I went, not knowing that he had already planned to arrest me. I got there, all of a sudden the policeman came and said, "Oh girl, you're under arrest." I said, "Okay. Let's go to the station and know why." When I got there, the guy wrote a statement against me. Accusation. Firstly, I told him that TBC is a cryptocurrency on a mission to eradicate poverty globally, and that if he joins, he has tendency of gaining interest from 1 to 5% daily. And of a truth, it reflects on his wallet. But because being a sheep that is always enslaved, he was not with his right senses. All of a sudden, he came up and said that TBC was a scam, that he needed his money back. Since he gave me the money, I should give him back. And he called police to arrest me. So, second accusation, that I sent guys to threaten him. I sent guys to go and threaten him. Well, I'm glad to share this today because of my conviction about TBC. No one directed me to TBC. It was God Himself. So it's divine. I know what I mean by when I say it is divine. I have a strong zeal, strong passion. Whatever it will cost for the world to become liberally free from the cage of the shepherd's whim, I will do it. So I went into the cell. It was on Friday night. I was there Friday night, Saturday night, then on Sunday morning, I've contacted people to come and sort this out so that I can come out from the place. So on Sunday, my mayor came, and later in the evening that Sunday, the case was settled, so I was granted bail. I came out, I was rejoicing because the guy has lost out. The guy has lost out. It was ignorance that pushed him to that act. So, and today I'm going stronger because TBC is getting stronger. Stronger and stronger every day. So my dear people, wow, amazing. If you're still thinking or having a doubt, please make up your mind now before it is too late. I've helped people, so many people, in terms of their Kringle $10 activation. I've done it for many, many. If you need help in your $10 payment fee, don't hesitate to contact me. I'll be leaving my contact details down this video. You can contact me through mail or WhatsApp, whichever one, or through voice call, whichever one. I'm available to help you out. And if you need, my send button is on. I've been doing transactions since January 25th, 2018, I've been doing transactions, and it's so fast, that's amazing, within less than 5 minutes. It's confirmed. So if you want to buy your $10, $100 TBC Kringle, one of Kringles, hesitate to contact me. I will help you out. You pay $100 and you have your $100 one of TBC in your wallet, and I'll help you set it up. And I will tell you today, all those groups that are saying ill statements against TBC, leave them. Leave those groups. Every information you need to get is in the TBC blog website, where we get educated. blog.thebilliontheBillionCoin.info. Get in there and read, study, follow up. Not get yourself confused. At this point, at this juncture,
I want to say a very big thank you to TBC admin. I'm so excited. Seriously, I'm so excited. I want to say thank you to all the top leaders in TBC community. And keep on the good work. Keep on the good work. Got TBC rocks.
So I want to inform you that, as usual, TBC promotion for the year, my group and my team and I, Crypto Abundance Group, we are planning on another journey. TBC promotion. So And it's going to be taking place soon, and I want everyone to be updated about it. I will update you guys then. Thank you very much. I'll be having my next video on the story about ego, why I prefer to be an ego, why I choose ego other than other birds. Like I'm choosing lion other than every other animals. Choose to be a lion today. See you at the top.